Good day to all science students. In this video lesson, we are going to discuss the amount of solute in a given mass of solvent, or we are going to make a computation about the percent by mass. Based on the previous lesson, read each sentence and categorize the underlined word based on how they are used in a situation. Choose your answer inside the box below. Okay, the salt mixed with water to make a brine solution. The underlined word is salt. The salt is pertaining to okay, solute. Water is used to dissolve powdered juice to make lemonade. Okay, the answer is solvent. The underlined word is water. You have 100 mm or millimeters of water and 45 grams of sugar to make a sugar solution. In making the solution, add the sugar little by little while stirring it. You observe that there is still sugar which is dissolving after a series of adding and stirring process. In this scenario, how will you describe the sugar solution? Okay, the answer is unsaturated kasi nakakapagtunaw pa po siya ng sugar. Number 4, in a brine solution, you use 35 grams of salt and 100 millimeters of water. Gradually, you put salt up to the last amount of it while stirring the water. You observe that no more salt is dissolving after completely adding 35 grams. Therefore, the brine solution is blank. Okay, saturated. When you mix a solute in a solvent, you form a homogeneous mixture called solution. So analyze and arrange the phrases together to define each word below correctly. Percent by mass is blank. The percent by mass is the amount of solute in a given mass of solution expressed as grams of solute per 100 grams of solution. Expressing concentration of solution. What does concentration of a solution means? Okay, a solution may be described in terms of the amount of solute it contains, which is referred to as the concentration of the solution. A solution may be described qualitatively as dilute or concentrated, or quantitatively based on percent composition. So, pwede natin describe ang solution in terms of being dilute or concentrated. Ano ba yung pagkakaiba ng dilute and concentrated? Or pwede rin i-describe natin quantitatively or exactly exact amount through percentage composition. So, parehas yung dalawang yan, ipapakita natin dito. Okay, dilute and concentrated. The term dilute and concentrated describe the relative amount of the solute in the solution. They do not indicate the exact amount of solute. Adding more solvent will make the solution more dilute. On the other hand, a concentrated solution has a high amount of solute. Adding more solute will make the solution more concentrated. So, para makita natin yung pagkakaiba pa ng dilute sa concentrated, ito pakita natin sa picture. For colored solute, such as dyes, the colors of the solution usually indicates the degree of its concentration. Concentrated solution have an intense or dark color, while the dilute solutions are pale or light in color. Alin dito sa part na to ang dilute at alin ang concentrated? Okay, itong medyo light, ito yung dilute. Yung mahina ang amount na nilagay natin na solute. At ito namang masyadong marami ang concentrated. Ang cold solute that is concentrated pero hindi pa siya tinatawag na saturated. Ano po? Concentrated siya pero hindi pa siya saturated kasi natunaw niya pa lahat. Okay, kagaya nito, yung pinakita natin dito sa video ito, tingnan natin itong last part. Ayan, sa una, medyo light yung colors yung nalagyan natin. Saturated at hanggang sa maging saturated siya. Ayan. Ayan, medyo light colors. Habang dinadamihan natin, yun, nagiging concentrated na siya. Yun, hanggang maging saturated. Kaya magkaiba yung concentrated sa saturated. Make an equation out of the information from the table. So, percent by mass, mass of solute, mass of solution, 100%. Yan yung apat na gagamitin natin. So, using this blank box, saan dyan ang position ng apat na yan? Okay, percent. The correct answer is percent by mass equals mass of solute, nasa taas, mass of solution times 100%. So, itry natin yung formula niyan in procedure. I-procedure natin. Paano ba tayo nagsosolve ng problem? Gagamitin natin yung formula niyan. Okay, step 1. Identify the given or what are given. Number 2. O, bawa, ang given ay mass of solute, mass of solution. Step number 2. What is asked? Ano ba yung itinatanong? What is the problem? and write this formula. Write the formula to be used. Step 4, you're going to substitute the formula by the given data and perform the necessary operation. And there are some products that are sold in the market showing the concentrations of solutes expressed as percent by mass or percent by volume. Kagaya ng alcohol, yung natin 70% isopropyl alcohol. O, ibig sabihin yun, the solution is 70% isopropyl alcohol or ethyl alcohol. It means that there is 70 mm of alcohol in every 100 mm of rubbing alcohol. Meaning, hindi siya pure alcohol. Okay, ito, i-compute na natin. So, mag-try na tayo ng sample problem. Calculate the mass percent of salt in a brine solution that is made by dissolving 13 grams of salt in 100 grams of water. So, unang step natin, identify the given. So, ang given po dyan, mass of solute, 13 grams of salt, mass of solution, 113 grams of water. Step number 2, what is asked? So, mass percent of salt ang hinahanap. So, write the formula to be used. Ito na yon, percent by mass, mass of solute divided by mass of solution times 100. And then, substitute now the formula. Okay, yung mass of solute is 13 grams. Yung mass of solution is 113 grams. Constant yung 100%. And then, divide muna natin 13 times. Okay, cancel muna natin itong mga units. And then, 13 divided by 113, the result is 0.115 times 100. That is 11.5 or 11.50%. Another problem. A certain player won third place in his game. And he was given a bronze medal made from copper and zinc. What is the mass percent of zinc in a bronze medal made by adding 22.5 gram of zinc to 427.5 gram of copper? So, same procedure. Identify the given. So, the given are mass of solute, 22.5 grams of zinc. And then, mass of solution, 427.5 grams of copper. And what is asked? So, mass percent of zinc. So, write the formula to be used. Ito yung same formula. Substitute the formula with the given data and perform the necessary operation. So, palitan lang natin yung mass of solute is 22.5 gram. Mass of solution is 427.5 grams times 100%. Cancel natin yung same units. And then, divide. And then multiply by 100, round off natin sa whole number, that is 5%. So, following the same procedure, kayo naman ang mag-solve nitong problem 2 and problem 3. Ayan, kayang-kaya nyo na po yan. And then, for our evaluation question, which of the following refers to the amount of matter in an object? The answer should be mass. Which of the following best describes percent by mass? The amount of space occupied by matter, the amount of matter in an object, it is the amount of solute in its volume of solution expressed as grams solute per 100 milliliters. It is the amount of solute in each mass of solvent expressed as grams solute per 100 ml. The answer should be